So, dear students, welcome for the study of supports in the subject of process equipment design or the chemical equipment design. Today we are going to discuss the bracket supports and the saddle support. Its designing aspects we'll consider today. First, coming to the bracket support. Now, this bracket support, they are also called as the lug supports. So, generally, this bracket supports, they are provided for these small diameter, big diameter vessels with a smaller height. The height is comparatively less and the diameters are more. Say 2 to 5 or 6 meters diameter, it can be used. And heights are in general case that can be from 2 meters to 5 meters or so. Now, so this bracket supports are fabricated from the plates and attached to the vessel with minimum possible weld length. So bracket supports, they are nothing but you have to provide a bracket. Now to this vessel, you are going to provide a certain bracket, and on this bracket, or it is nothing but you are stiffening plates. Initially, the stiffening plate that is to be provided, first it is to be welded stiffening plate, or that is also called as the backing plate, reinforcing plate. This is your reinforcing plate, or it is also called as the backing plate. Now, on this reinforcing plate, I am going to put the two plates, that is the stiffener plate and the gusset plate. The horizontal one is your stiffener plate and verticals are your gusset plates. So, coming to this figure, the basically, the reinforcing plate that is provided to the wall. This is your reinforcing plate. So that it provides the strength to the shell of the vessel. So you are first making or improving the strength of the shell in the area where you are going to provide a bracket. Then you are going to provide the two vertical plates. They are nothing but your gusset plates. These two vertical plates, they are called as the gusset plates. Gusset plates. And the two horizontal plates, they are called as the stiffener plates. So in between the gusset plate and the stiffener plate, both are welded to the backing plate. Backing plate is nothing but a reinforcing. This is your backing plate or the reinforcing plate. And then they are provided with these columns. So that is going to rest on these columns. Sometimes in the inside of the building, they can be resting on the floor also. Instead of putting these columns, they can be resting on the floor itself. So that means a floor that is available, and this will rest on this floor. Building floor jo kuch hai, uske upar wo rest hoga. Vessel. So you will save this column structure in those cases. So generally they are less costly and can be easily attached to the vessel with minimum weld length. Can be easily leveled. Leveling is easy and it is very important. Load should be uniformly distributed. They can absorb the diametrical expansion. That means when it is on the floor or the vertical columns are there, the expansion because of the temperature changes, then this can be accommodated because of the horizontal plates. And most suitable for the tank wall vessels because of their ability to absorb the bending stresses due to the eccentricity of the load. So this is now coming to the notations. This is the H is the total height from the bottom, that is from the ground. C, that is the clearance from the bottom, that is there is no vessel up to the C, means vessel height, actual vessel height is H minus C, is the actual vessel height, that is from this to the complete vessel. This is H minus C. Then R is the reaction that is going to take place. Then L, that is here, this is the L which is provided in between the vertical axis of the column and the vessel shell. Then PW is nothing but your wind load. So this wind load is acting on which length? H minus C. Wind load that will act on this H minus C length. And this total weight that will be resting or providing the reaction at these four brackets. This is provided with the four brackets. If the vessels are small, up to 2 meter diameter, then the two brackets, they are sufficient. But above 2 meters diameter, the four brackets or 6 brackets or 8 brackets, depending on the diameter and the weight, all these number of brackets are to be decided. Now coming to the mathematical aspects. So in general, basically the thickness of the plates are to be calculated. That is the basic purpose. The thickness of the horizontal plate that and the thickness of the vertical plate is to be calculated. Thickness of this horizontal plate and the thickness of this vertical plate, that is to be calculated, because all the load that is going to rest or has to be balanced by these two plates. So we have to calculate the thickness for these two. Now in general, the load first that is to be calculated, then what is the bending moment, and then the different stresses. After the calculation of stresses, we have to check it for the material strength and finally decide the thickness. So the load first that we will calculate, that is P is the maximum total compressive load on the bracket due to the wind and the dead load. Now what is W? Is nothing but the dead load. W is the dead load, total weight of the vessel and its content. And this is because of the wind, the load because of the wind. PW is nothing but your wind force acting over the vessel. PW is the wind force acting over the vessel. Then H, I have already told, is the total height. C is the clearance between the vessel. So this wind load that is acting on this height only, PW into H minus C. Now DB is your bolt circle diameter. DB is the bolt circle diameter, and N, that is the number of brackets. So this total weight is distributed in so many number of brackets. That means ultimately this column that is going to have a total weight that is distributed in between those four columns or four supports. That is why we are distributing, dividing it by the N, that is the number of brackets. Now, if the vessel is inside the building, if the vessel is inside the building, so this term PW, that is wind force acting on the vessel, that will become equals to the zero. So, if the vessel is located in a closed premises, that is inside the building, so PW that becomes zero, and your equation incorporates only the dead weight. So this is the load that we have calculated first. Then the bracket consists of two horizontal plates, that is your stiffeners, and the two vertical gusset plates. All these plates are welded to the vessel shell. Now the maximum tensile and compressive stresses induced in the stiffener plate. Therefore, the plates are continuously welded to the shell and the gusset plates are intermittently welded. Gusset plates are your vertical plates. Vertical plates can be intermittently welded. So, the axial bending stresses induced in the vessel wall due to the compressive load. That is, Fa is nothing but your axial bending stresses. This is induced because of the bending moment. So, first we will calculate the bending moment. Now, bending moment, first we have calculated the load, then the bending moment, and then the stresses. So, bending moment that is calculated as beta cube T square PLR square upon 6 into bracket 1 minus mu square into AH. Where beta that is your constant, and this constant is calculated from this equation incorporating the radius and the thickness plus the mu, that is your Poisson's ratio. Then T is the vessel wall thickness, R is the radius of the vessel shell. P is the load which we have calculated in the previous step. L that is nothing but the distance from the center line of the shell plate. That is the distance from the center line of the shell plate. Distance line from the shell plate, center line of the shell plate to the center line of the column, to the center line of the column. This distance is nothing but your L. Then A, that is the width of compression plate. A is the width of the compression plate. This is A, the width of the compression plate. Compression plate is nothing but your stiffener plate. These stiffener plates are in compression because niche se usko support mil raha hai, column ke upar rest hai, so it will be under compression. So this plate is under compression. This plate is under compression. So total weight is being distributed ho raha hai. So after calculation of the M and the beta, then coming to the stresses. So Fa which is equal to the M upon T square by 6. m is the bending moment. So this stresses that will be calculated. Then the thickness of the horizontal plate, that is your thickness of the stiffener plate, which is under compression, that will be nothing but TH, which is equal to 6 m maximum upon f, where f is the permissible stresses of that plate. So we have calculated the stresses, axial bending stresses, and this will be used to calculate the total horizontal plate thickness. So similarly, the gusset plate thickness, that will also be calculated as the TG, is the thickness of the gusset plate, which is P by 2 into FC into the S. FC is your permissible compressive strength, S is the width of the gusset plate, and RG is the radius of the gyration, TG is the gusset plate thickness. So this is related to the calculation of the thickness of the horizontal plates, that is your stiffener plate, and which are in compression, and the gusset plates, that is your vertical plates. Now this column supports for the bracket. The below is your column supports. So this is what first we have talked related to this bracket. Now we are going to talk related to this support, right? This is what is support. This bracket is resting on the support column. So column support for the bracket, that is to be decided. The columns are attached under the brackets and rest over the concrete foundation. This column is attached in such a manner that it can be considered as the column under concentric axial load. The load acting over the column is compressive, and compressive stresses induced can be related to the radius of gyration of the column. This compressive stresses, that will be calculated considering the radius of the gyration RG. So since the column is located at a distance A from the vessel wall, it eccentrically induces the additional stress in the column. So FC, which is equal to PA upon Z. Now if the vessel is located in the open area, the wind load will also include the bending stresses in the column. So your formula will change when the vessel is outside the building. So that will be PW upon N into L upon 2 upon the Z stresses because of the wind. So this is the designing related to the bracket supports or the lug supports. Bracket supports, they are called as the lug support also. Now second is the designing of the saddle support. So saddle supports, they are only provided for the horizontal vessels. So horizontal vessels are to be considered. Now coming, see this horizontal vessel. So you have to consider this vessel with the two heads which are provided at the two ends. So the length of the vessel plus the extended part of the head, that is to be taken into account. And they are to be provided with this such type of the saddles. So saddle, that will be considered, or this type of the saddle that has to be considered. So the front view will look for the saddle will look like this, and the side view will look like this. Now L is the total length of the cylindrical part. L is the total length of the cylindrical part, and H is the head height. So generally the length that is considered to be the two-third of the H effective length. So total length will be L plus two-third H from this side plus this side also. So multiplied by 2 because there are two heads. So it will become your 4 by 3 into the H plus the L, that will give you the total length. So L plus 4 by 3 into H, this is the equivalent cylinder having this length. The equivalent cylinder having the length equal to L plus 4 upon 3H. Because there are two heads on the two sides, therefore 2/3 H multiplied by 2, that is going to give you the 4 upon 3H. Now A is the distance from the cylindrical part to the center of the saddle support, and the Q are the reactions at the two loads. Q is the reaction at each load. The reaction at each saddle support is nothing but the Q, and it will be considered as a horizontal beam. A cylinder is considered to be as a horizontal beam. That is why we have calculated the effective length of a cylinder. So it is considered to be as a beam, and when the beam that is supported at the two parts, it will have the bending moment, and its bending moment diagram will become like this. So in the center, M1 is the bending moment at the center, and M2, that is the bending moment at the two supports. M2, that is the bending moment at the two supports. That will be there. So the horizontal vessel resting on the saddle support, that is what? The vessel behaves like a beam. Because we have considered this as your equivalent length, which is equal to L plus 4 upon 3H. The number of saddles are generally 2. It can be more if unavoidable. So supports in the form of ring are preferred if it is required at more than 2 positions. In selecting the location of the saddle support, advantages of stiffening effect offered by the head is taken into account. With this view, the location of the saddle support is done at a distance of 0.4 R from the tangent line of the vessel shape. And this distance should not exceed the 20% of the tangent to tangent length of the vessel. The angle theta, that is considered to be as the 120. This is nothing but your theta angle. It is considered to be the 120 degree. In order to calculate the reaction at the two saddle supports, weight of the vessel with its contents, that is to be considered, to be calculated. For a hemispherical or elliptical head vessel, it can be treated as an equivalent cylinder having the length L plus 4 upon 3H. Now, the weight of a vessel is assumed to act to the center of the vessel by considering it as a uniformly loaded beam. So the reaction at each saddle support, Q is the reaction at each saddle support. So W is your total weight, that is it, kg, and this L plus 4 upon 3 H, that is meters. So W is uniformly distributed load and Q is the reaction at each saddle support. So calculating this bending moment at the center and bending moment at the support, that is calculated as using this formula, and for the support it is calculated by using this formula. So once the bending moment, first we have calculated the stresses, then the bending moment, first we have calculated the load, then the bending moment, and then the stresses. So coming to the stresses part, so stresses are in the longitudinal and they are in the tangential or circumferential direction. These stresses, they are in the longitudinal and the circumferential or tangential direction. When you talk the stresses in the longitudinal direction, then the stresses at the highest position, stresses at the middle position, and stresses at the axial position, midspan, center, that is to be considered. This is related to the longitudinal stresses, that is at the topmost, at the bottommost, and at the center. When the vessels are vertical and the liquid pressure is uniformly distributed, then these stresses are uniform. However, this vessel is horizontal and supported at the two bottoms, so it will become your stresses at the three parts. That is the longitudinal stresses at the highest point, longitudinal stresses at the midspan, and the longitudinal stresses at the bottom. So the longitudinal bending stresses at the bottommost part, that is calculated as 4 times m1 upon pi by 4 d square into t into the k2. So similarly, the stresses induced in the mid span, that is calculated as m1 upon pi by 4 d square into the t. And the F1 is this, that is at the highest point of the cross section, which is nothing but the F1. So M2 into pi by 4 d square into t into the K1. Now this K1 and K2, that will depend on the angle for the shell not stiffened by the head or the ring, and A is greater than 0.5 R, this K1 will have the value of 0.107 for theta is equal to 120 degrees, 0.16 for theta is equal to 150 degrees, and K2 will have the value of 0.19 and theta, which is equal to 120. So these are the values of K1 and K2 depending on the angle. Now these are the longitudinal stresses. The second stresses is the circumferential stresses or the tangential stresses. So tangential stresses, circumferential stresses, that is to be considered at the support at the support means at this area, the tangential or circumferential stresses that is to be considered on the surface of the vessel. Then in the head and in the other shell. So for the circumferential stresses, we will calculate at the support, at the shell and at the head. So these three stresses, circumferential stresses, that will be now calculated. So F4 is at the support. Supports also have to carry the tangential shear stresses arising from the supported part of the shell, which is calculated as K3Q upon RT into L minus 2A minus H upon L plus H, where K3 that is the constant and again have the value of 1.17 and 0.8 depending on the value of theta. So the maximum tangential stresses arising from the unsupported part of the shell, unsupported part of the shell, that is F5 and F6. F5 is nothing but in the cylindrical shell and F6 is nothing but the head. So these are the circumferential stresses or the tangential stresses. So that is, this is the circumferential stresses in the supported part and the circumferential stresses in the unsupported part, that is other than this. So we are having the total six stresses we have talked. Three is for the longitudinal stresses, that is at the highest position, then at the midspan and then at the bottommost section. These are the longitudinal stresses. Then the circumferential stresses, that is at the support and at the unsupported part, plus the free end, unsupported part of the shell and the free end of the shell. So these six stresses we have considered. Then there is a stiffener plate which is provided to increase the strength in the supported part. The saddle support arranged for a small diameter vessel. Okay, this is nothing but your stiffener plate. This is the stiffener plate which is provided. This is your basically the shell stiffener plate, and these are your saddle supports. It can be intermittent or it can be uniform also. So this is the stiffener plate. Now this stiffener plate is in between this shell and the bracket and the saddle. So it will be under compression. This will be under compression. So the stresses at the stiffening ring, Stiffening plate is welded to the shell over the saddle, and this is under compression. So the compressive stresses, that is calculated as K7Q upon AR plus minus K8QR upon Z. So this is related to the ring stiffness.